Hey Trumpet Nerds! Today, I'm showing you a new twist on a well-known method of adjusting your mouthpiece gap, the threaded gap sleeves by Frost Custom Brass. These threaded sleeves are so slick, and we'll get to them in a minute, but first, let's talk about mouthpiece gap. When I say mouthpiece gap, I'm talking about the space between the end of the mouthpiece and the beginning of the lead pipe, inside the trumpet's receiver. Gap is not about the amount that the mouthpiece sticks out of the trumpet, because mouthpieces are different lengths, but rather the size of this gap. So how would you change a mouthpiece gap? Well, there are several ways, but the most common is just to use a mouthpiece gap sleeve, a modular component of a mouthpiece that lets you change how big the gap will be. Is mouthpiece gap actually a thing? Yes! It might seem super niche, like maybe only for the most egregiously nerdy trumpet players out there, but there has actually been a ton of research done about mouthpiece gap and its effect on trumpet and mouthpiece combinations. Mouthpiece makers like Bob Reeves Brass Mouthpieces and Stomvi, who also manufacture their own versions of gap sleeves, have entire videos and web pages dedicated to the subject. You can find links to their sites in the description below if you want to find out more. So, most gap sleeves on the market use an O-ring to secure the gap sleeve onto the modified shank of the mouthpiece, such as the ones made by Bob Reeves and Stomvi. Theoretically, threads would allow for a more stable multi-part mouthpiece, playing more similarly to a one-piece mouthpiece than one might with an O-ring. Because O-rings are made of rubber, that material is likely to absorb some of the vibrations of the mouthpiece while it's being played. Also, because rubber can be compressed, the sleeve could potentially move slightly up and down the shank when the pressure is applied, leading to small variations in the actual mouthpiece gap measurement. That variation might be extremely small, but mouthpiece gap is a very precise measurement, and even super small changes like what you'd see in that situation could have an effect on the sound. How do you actually use mouthpiece gap sleeves? So in order to use these sleeves, you first have to get your mouthpiece modified to accept them. In the case of the Frost threaded sleeves, you send him the mouthpiece or the screwback bore that you want sleeved, and he will remove a bunch of metal around the shank of the mouthpiece and carve out threads to accept the sleeves. You can see that my Park orchestral back bore has thin walls at the bottom even before modification. So after the metal has been removed for sleeves, the walls are so thin, I'm sure I could squish it with my fingers. To keep the back bore in top condition, Matt recommended storing the back bore with a sleeve installed. I got 6 sleeves from Matt to experiment with, his stock sleeve sizes, which are numbered 1 through 5, as well as a custom one, the 2.5, which has the same mouthpiece gap as the original Park backbore did. So now that we have these new sleeves, how does the gap size affect how the mouthpiece and trumpet combination performs? While experimenting with all these different gap sleeves, I felt that increasing and decreasing the gap seemed to have predictable effects that felt linear, so I will show you just the sizes that are farthest apart to try to accentuate the differences. I found that the smaller gap sleeves had a more brilliant sound, and the larger gap sleeves had a bit of a darker sound. The articulation felt a little crisper with the smaller gap and a little bit more muffled with the larger gap. Finally, I found that when playing flexibility exercises, the slotting on the smaller sleeves was a bit more slippery, while the bigger sleeves had much more secure slots that seemed to pop more. In terms of feel from the player standpoint, it kind of felt like the smaller gap sleeves were a little bit more open in feel, whereas the larger gap sleeves felt more restricted. I did notice some difference in intonation between the various sleeves, but didn't really notice anything consistent. So which one did I like best? Actually, I preferred the 2.5 sleeve, which was somewhere in the middle. Some of you might remember that the 2.5 is exactly the same gap as the original Park mouthpiece was. You might be thinking,
wow, John, what a waste of time.
But actually, there are several really good reasons to use gap sleeves, which I'll get into a little later. By the way, if you're enjoying this trumpet equipment deep dive, consider subscribing to John Talks Trumpet for more videos like this. The sleeves themselves are machined beautifully and thread onto the mouthpiece shank very easily. Many of you are familiar with threads on mouthpieces from either threaded rims or backbores, and these sleeves add a third set of threads to maintain. Pro tip, anytime you're using threads, make sure that you reverse thread, which means trying to turn on the component counterclockwise first until you hear a little click, and that means that you're aligned with thread so you don't accidentally damage them while forcing it on. And also, make sure you use some slide grease or lanolin on the threads to keep the parts from getting stuck together. You might think with an extra layer, the sleeves might add extra weight to the mouthpiece, but really the change is extremely small. Enough metal is removed that the modified mouthpiece with the sleeve actually ends up being a very similar weight to the original mouthpiece. So what are the benefits of using gap sleeves like this? The first and most obvious is that you can try to dial in the gap on your main horn and mouthpiece. But honestly, if you like your current setup, the chances are that your gap is at a perfectly suitable size already, and maybe the sleeves could be a bit of a fishing expedition. Another convenient use for sleeves is if you've been playing a horn for a really long time, or it's really old and the receiver is worn down a bit and allows the mouthpiece to seat further in than it used to, you can just use a sleeve a half size or a full size bigger to correct the gap. In my opinion, you probably stand to gain the most from having a gap sleeve system if you play with a lot of different horns with your same main mouthpiece. Because different brands and types of trumpets will have different size mouthpiece receivers and sometimes a completely different construction, a different gap sleeve might be just what you need to dial in the feel for each horn that you play on. Really, using mouthpiece gap sleeves is by far the most practical way to be able to use the exact same mouthpiece on lots of different kinds of trumpets. One recommendation I will make is that when you get your mouthpiece sleeves, ask Matt Frost for a sleeve that will match the original insertion of your mouthpiece. Yes, the average might be around a 3-sleeve, but each mouthpiece is different. Even mouthpieces from the same company and in the same configuration may create different mouthpiece gaps. To see this in practice, check out this table that Matt Frost made of the common insertion for various brands. There's almost no pattern to it at all. Check out the link in the description. It costs $45 to convert a mouthpiece or screw backbore to accept the Frost threaded sleeves, and each sleeve is $35. I got these in silver plate to match my current pieces, but they are also available in raw brass or gold plate. Thanks to Matt for helping make this video possible. I got in touch with him about buying a few of these sleeves and the backbore conversion, and he was willing to throw in some extra sleeves at no cost so this video could be as educational as possible for you all. Matt Frost is a true brass nerd and offers a lot of unique products on his website, so be sure to check out Frost Custom Brass's website as well as Facebook and Instagram pages to see more of his incredible engineering and craftsmanship. The sleeves themselves are really impressive, and I'm glad there's another option for the nerds out there looking to perfect their mouthpiece gap. Thanks so much for joining me for this episode of John Talks Trumpet, and I'll see you on my next nerdy trumpet adventure.